Today I'm going to show you how to get your video statistics in the YouTube title of whatever video you pick that you own. Mind you, there is one massive thing that may block you on your journey, and that is if you have a YouTube brand account, you will be unable to do this. I've tried, and I've done a lot of research, and I gave up. So you must have a YouTube account that is not a brand account. Anyways, what you need to do is you first need to go to the first link in the description and you will see scripts.google.com thing. Just click new project. Then when you have this new project here, we want to rename the project to literally anything. This is just for organization's sake. So I've renamed it to something really easy. And now what you need to do is you just need to clear all of this code, delete it. Then you just need to go to the second link in the description, click on the webpage, press Control A, then press Control C to copy it. Then go back into your Google Script Apps thing and paste it in with Control V. Then when you do that, you will see a whole bunch of code. And before we even do anything, you need to click on the plus button on services. Then you need to scroll down to YouTube Data API V3, click on that, then click add. And what that's going to do is add the API that allows us to communicate with YouTube. Now that that's done, you need to get the ID of this video that you want to change the title of. So how do we get that? Well, you need to go to your YouTube studio and you need to get a video that is either unlisted or public. It cannot be private or else it won't work. All you need to do is click on the details button. Then you will see this video link here. All this stuff past the slash after YouTube is going to be your video ID. So copy it with Control C, then go back to your project editor and paste it in between these quotes. Then once you do that, you need to get your channel ID. Now the easiest way of getting this is going back into your YouTube studio, just clicking on the home button. And when you do that, go up to your URL bar and the chunk of text after the channel slash is going to be your YouTube ID. So copy that, then go to your project editor, whatever it's called again, and you need to paste it in between the quotation marks on line 12. So right here, I'm going to paste it in. And now that that's done, we actually get to customize the video title. So I zoomed in a little bit to make it easier to see, but from line 18 to 25, we actually have a list of video title variables. These are going to be the numerical variables that we are going to stick into our title to express values. So in this case, we have video views, video likes, video dislikes, video comments. Those are self-explanatory. That's going to be the number of views, likes, dislikes, and comments on a specific video. Then we have channel subs, channel videos, and channel views. That's going to be the total amount of subscribers that the channel has, the total number of videos that the channel has, and the total number of views. Now, how do we actually set the video title of our video? Well, that's actually from section or line 27 to 31. And this is where we actually configure the title of the video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove all of the information after the equal sign on line 31. And when I do that, place a semicolon, then go behind the semicolon. Then you want to put in two apostrophes. This will give you quotation marks in which you want to type the title of your video. So to make this all simple, I'm going to go back to the YouTube studio and I'm going to go to my video and I'm just going to make a fake title on what I actually want it to be. So I want to say, this video has, then for any numerical value, like any of the numbers that the program needs to update, just give it like a letter variable like X or Y or Z. So I'm going to say this video has X views, comma, Y likes, comma, and Z dislikes. So literally just anything. The whole point is that when this is done, I want it to say this video has 100 views, 2 likes, 0 dislikes, or something like that. Once you have that set up, you just need to copy the title. Then you need to go back into the script editor, then go to line 31, like we were before, and paste this text that you copied in between the two quotation marks. When you do that, you'll see that it says, this video has X views, Y likes, and Z dislikes. What we want to do is we want to put an apostrophe before and after each one of those variables. So for X, I'm going to put an apostrophe before and after it. Then for Y, I'm going to do the same thing, apostrophe before and after. Then for Z, I'm going to put an apostrophe before and after. So after you put in the apostrophes before and after each variable, we actually need to replace the variable with the actual code so it makes sense to the program. So from line 18 to line 25, like I said, these are your variables, and we need to find the variable that we want. So in this case for X, we need to look for views because we want to say this video has 100 views. So we look for views. In this case, we have video views and channel views. I only want this to apply to the video, so I'm going to select video views, press Control C to copy it. Then I am going to delete the X and paste in that variable. Now, before you do anything else, you need to add a plus sign after and before what you just pasted in. Now that you do that, it should say this video has, and then apostrophe, plus video views, plus then views and all the other stuff. And now we just need to do that for all the other variables. So we have likes, and we want to figure out the number of video likes. So we go to line 20 and we see video likes. We copy that. Make sure you copy the whole thing or else it won't work because it is case sensitive. Delete the Y, paste it in, put a plus sign after and before the variable name or the thing that we copy and pasted. Then go to Z and we want to figure out the dislikes. So we go to line 21, copy video dislikes, and we replace it with Z, or we replace Z with it. Then we add the plus signs before and after it. And now that we have that, we just need to run the code. So click on the run button. Then you'll see this execution log and it'll say attempted to execute my function, but it was deleted. That's fine. You just need to press the run button again and it should run properly. To figure out if the code works, you should see this window pop up saying authorization required. Click review permissions. Then you want to select your YouTube account. Mind you, if you have a brand account, like I said before, this won't work. Trust me. I wouldn't have made this whole entire different Minecraft YouTube channel just for this video, although I kind of want to. Just click on your YouTube account to sign in. It'll say Google hasn't verified this app. Click advanced, then click go to, then whatever you name the project name. When you click on that, it'll say it wants to manage your YouTube account. Click allow. Then what it will do is authenticate correctly and it'll say execution started and execution completed. Then once it runs, you might need to just go back to your studio dashboard, then click on contents, and you should see that your title now says this video has 0 views, 0 likes, and 0 dislikes. That means it works, right? Technically, yes. Let's just give it a try real quick. Let's watch the video. And I'm gonna like my own video because I'm just an absolute crazy person. Now, mind you, if you watch your own YouTube video, it might not actually count as a view, but this like 100% will count. Now that I've given the video a like and I refresh the page and you see that there is one like, technically speaking, if I refresh the page, it should say that I now have one like. You are correct, but our code actually doesn't run just magically. We need to give it a trigger or an event that will actually run the code. So we need to go back to our app script Google thingy thing, then go to the left and you will see triggers. You want to click on that. Then it'll pop up here and we want to click add trigger at the bottom right. Then we want to click stats title and make sure that's selected. All this other stuff is fine, but this time driven thing should be the event source. You should see hour timer. We want to change this to minutes timer. Then we want to select our minute interval to every 10 minutes. The reason why we're going to update this every 10 minutes is because if you have it updating every minute, it'll saturate YouTube's API and you'll have a cooldown and basically your code will only work about 60% of the time. So keeping it at 10 minutes should keep you safe. When you have that done, you just want to click save. And what will happen is that now every 10 minutes, this code will run and it will update your YouTube title to actually match the video statistics. But I'm lazy and I don't trust it yet. So you need to click on editor, then click run on the code. It'll say execution started, execution completed. If we go back to our YouTube studio and refresh, you'll notice now this video has 0 views, 1 likes, and 0 dislikes. And that is how you set your title to do all this YouTube statistics stuff. It's pretty fun. And that wraps up the installation portion of the video. If it worked, like and subscribe. And if you want to support the channel even further, just turn off your ad blocker when you watch my videos. And if for some odd reason it didn't work out for you, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section or join my Discord and put your issue in the help channel and I will help you out as soon as I can. Now let's get on to the uninstall portion of the video. Now to undo all this wizardry, all we need to do is go back into our scripts.google.com. Then we just need to go to triggers. Then we need to click on our three dots for our trigger and click delete trigger. And what that will do is it will prevent the code from automatically updating. Then we can go back to our YouTube studio and change the title like normal. Any hoot hollering and a half, that is the end of the video. I had played Minecraft for about 40 minutes and edited for about 3.5 hours, it feels like. And that's the Minecraft video that you guys really wanted. Technoblade is no longer here anymore. He is gone. Au revoir. Mwah.